You know, I got to tell you, Jennifer, one of the things that has really impressed me as we continue to watch this service at Prospect Cemetery. I earlier this morning tweeted out a picture of a poppy.
Yeah.
And asked people to change their avatars today to the poppy.
Yeah.
It has been retweeted hundreds of times. I'm loving all the poppies showing up on Twitter right now.
I've seen Facebook profiles as well, people putting up the poppy.
It's so important now because as we get further and further away from major conflicts, of course, we've gone through our trials in Afghanistan where we have lost many of our soldiers, but from the great wars from World War I, World War II, and they were called the great wars at the time. Mm-hmm. It's not indicating they were wonderful. It was just they were the great wars because they were so massive. The further we get away from that, we hit the danger of forgetting.
You know, we wear our poppy leading up to Remembrance Day. You see a lot of people wearing poppies all year long, Kev.
And there's nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that at all. And remember, what you do with your poppy, too, is at the end of November the 11th, you don't put it away till next year. You're supposed to go to a cenotaph and leave your poppy there. Mm-hmm. Now, we are going to join this from time to time here on Breakfast Television. We have time constraints, unfortunately. So this year, thank you, Winston, for arranging this. We have the entire ceremony right now live at BreakfastTelevision.ca. Just scroll down the page and you'll find a Remembrance Day live stream.
Excuse me, sir.
So please, if you could go there and watch that and observe. You can watch the entire ceremony uninterrupted, no commentary. No talk, just you can watch the entire ceremony as though you're there.
Of course, at 11 o'clock today, the 11th hour, we will remember.
We do need to take a break right now on Breakfast Television. We'll go back live to this in just a few minutes. Stay with us.